an alligator gets in your swimming pool, in your backyard, or even inside your house, who are you going to call? The Gator Boys.
When alligators venture from their natural habitats, it's the team of Paul Bedard and Jimmy Riffle who go in after them.
My name is Paul Bedard. I am not crazy.
Paul, watch it, watch it.
All right, here.
On Animal Planet's Gator Boys, they catch wayward reptiles and return them to safety before they're caught by trappers or harm humans.
Every gator I catch is a gator that doesn't die.
Maybe your idea of fun doesn't include wrestling deadly gators, but for Paul, it's more than a dangerous job.
Unbelievable. Please welcome to the 700 Club, Paul Bedard and his gator. Great to have you with us.
Thanks.
Both of you. Does your friend have a name?
Yeah, this is Junior.
Junior? How big is Junior going to get?
Hopefully, 12, 13 feet.
Really? Can I touch him?
Sure.
Oh, he's great. I don't know, Pat. I think that was pretty insensitive to mention shoes. It's okay, Junior. Not here. Well, Paul, CBN has been on the air for many years. This is the first time we've ever had a gator in our studio, and so we welcome both of you. How'd you get into this? I mean, what in the world made you say one day, I think I'll wrestle that thing?
Yeah, I don't know what it is. Everybody's kind of born with something you have a passion for. And I grew up, I used to love, rattlesnakes, and I wasn't really into
the
cute
stuff.
Cute fluffies. I was a hardcore little boy.
Yeah.
And I liked all the dangerous animals.
This is very dangerous, this line of work you've gotten into. I'm looking at the teeth that he's got, which are numerous. You've been bitten many times.
Yeah, I stopped counting at 25, so I'd say upwards of 30 at least.
Five times on your head?
Yeah.
You look pretty scar-free, that's good.
Yeah, it's not too bad. I've been very lucky, actually.
Did these guys get a bad rap?
Yeah, for the most part, especially, a lot of people in Florida, they'll move down from New England, New Jersey or something, and they buy a house in the Everglades, essentially, and they freak out and there's a gator in the backyard. Well, you kind of moved into their habitat, so it's going to happen.
Now, you actually do provide the service I talked about, going into places where gators get into private property or places that they
golf courses,
golf courses,
things like that.
Exactly.
Yep. Happens a lot.
How do you catch one of these things?
There's many different ways. A lot of guys will use like a snag hook on a fishing pole. And if the water's real murky and I can't see him, that's one of the ways. But if he's in crystal clear water, which, by the grace of God, we have a lot of in Broward County, I can just swim down underwater, and they're very mellow underwater. They're very,
really?
They're very approachable underwater. They don't really see you. As
is
a
their
threat.
Vision not good?
Yeah, their vision's a little, it's a little shaky. It's probably like ours would be without a mask or a snorkel on, but obviously I have the ability to put a mask on and see better than he can.
So now here we see you just carrying this large gator away, but do you have to kind of...
Yeah, you got to tire him out first. It's not, you just don't go in and grab him. That doesn't work.
How does one tire out a gator?
well, they're reptiles, so they're ectothermic or cold-blooded, so it doesn't take very long.
Wow.
10 or 15 minutes, just chase them around, playing with them. And, sometimes they'll come at you and you got to learn how to defend yourself to keep them away. But their number one goal is to get away from you. Uh-huh. They may make one lash you and then they see an escape route and they go for it. Yeah. But they do that a few times, they get tired.
But they're dangerous at both ends, right? The mouth and the tail.
Yeah, everybody thinks the tail is really dangerous. It is, but not compared to the mouth.
Yeah.
The mouth's where all the crushing power is. It's where the teeth are.
Given the option.
I'll go with the tail.
I mentioned the insensitive remark about shoes. I do want to mention that when you do catch these gators in people's property or on people's property or at golf courses, you don't kill them? You don't do
No, we will put them in a preserve, or if they're under 4 feet, we can release them back into the wild.
Huh.
Anything bigger than that must be kept in captivity. Most are destroyed because as a trapper, you don't get paid. You're paid with the alligator. So most people will harvest the animal.
Uh-huh.
But to me, they're like my kids, so I can't do that.
Now, it seems to me in your line of work that this should be a given, but you are a man of faith.
Absolutely. And they say there's no atheist in foxholes.
Yeah.
There's no atheist when you're messing with
a
gator,
sure,
in my mind.
I'm sure that's true. How did you come to know the Lord?
It, like with a lot of people, it develops over time. And, it was really more of a trial and error thing. I just said, the more I follow Christ's teachings, the better my life gets,
yes,
and the easier your life gets.
Yeah.
And it's really that simple. That's where it started, and then it takes a foothold, and you really start to open your mind up and realize, this is the real deal.
Well, God has certainly protected you in the work that you've chosen with these precious animals. Precious, that would be a good name for this one, wouldn't it? He's really, I just can't stop touching the skin. It's so interesting. What do you feed him?
Mostly you know, chicken, and it's actually like a gator chow. It's like dog food for alligators. It has everything that the chicken doesn't.
Now, is this truly your gator?
No, this is a friend of mine. He brought this in from Pennsylvania.
Oh, I thought you meant the gator. I was going to say, okay.
Oh, he's a friend of mine, too.
Now, he's very docile right now. Why?
He's used to being handled a lot.
Really?
So when that happens, they do get used to human contact and realize you're not a threat.
Uh-huh.
A wild gator doesn't have that reaction because you're a predator to him. And that's when it gets really dangerous.
What's the most difficult situation you've ever been put in as far as having to catch a gator?
There's a lot of them. There's a lot. The ones that we caught in Mississippi while we were down there, those were a challenge because it was a different terrain than I'm used to. I'm used to crystal clear water. I'm used to coral rock bottoms in Mississippi. There's a lot of mud. We get stuck up to our waist. Get in the water. I found a few gators by bumping them with my head underwater. So,
Paul, there's got to be a better way.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Let those Mississippians catch their own gators. Yeah. I'd stick them for it.
My technique weren't so good for Mississippi off the bat.
Well, people love the show. They really do. You have a great following.
That.
And I think you've given people a new appreciation for an animal that has been around a long time and that really, in its own way, is very beautiful.
Yeah, well,
thank you for being with us today.
Okay,
it's great to have you here. Wow. Well, if you'd like to see more of Paul's wrestling gators, and who wouldn't like to see that, you can watch him and his partner Jimmy on Animal Planet's Gator Boys. That's Sunday nights at 9 p.m. Eastern Time. You can also go to CBN.com for a web exclusive with Paul. All you have to do is click on the In the Green Room link. There he goes. And Patty must have heard the shoe comment because he's moving away from you with as much speed as he can muster on our slick floor here.
I'd make a nice pair of loafers. Right. Hey, those things, by the way, we talked about old. I think the crocodiles and the alligators may go back hundreds of millions of years. They're some of the first that ever hit this planet, so they're survivors.
And he's hearing your nice comments, and he's rounding
the coming back. He's coming back. I'm complimenting him. All right. Hey, Terry, why don't you... How old are these things? I mean, do they say?
You mean this?
Yeah, but I mean the species itself.
The species itself.
They say up to 250 million years.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
But I'm not sure how they pinpoint that. So,
right. A gator told them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, he's going someplace. He likes it here. All right. Okay. Well, don't be careful. If there's a dog out, he'll find us lunch. All right.